call for a truck and trailer that turned too sharp, and he's up on something, he's got the trailer leaning pretty good. So we're gonna boogie over here. I guess I should have went. Hook him up. Lift him up. Spin him around. Send him back down. It must be like inside the yard. Because the pictures I got, it shows he's like up next to something. There's our black Durango. Our guy. Jesus Christ. I did not realize that there was a huge ass hole right there. I probably just broke it even more. That they make like out here. Like they just like got, somebody just has all this land and they just start, I don't know, paving a road maybe. And then they do stuff like that, like little lot yards, like, oh, that's Craig's lot over there. I know you can see how huge I am coming down the road. Better, right? How much is in it? How much is in it?
41,000.
What is it? Do you know what it is?
Sugar.
Sugar, so it's about midway. It's not stacked all the way to the top,
no,
then.
It's not stacked.
Midway, okay. Picking it and
swinging it over is going to be our best. I think picking it and swinging it over is going to be our best bet. All right, I'm going to just pick it up and move it over. I'm going to pick it up and then set it right here. Because instead of you pulling you straight back, I mean, not only do you got wheels off the ground,
yeah,
in the front, but if I pull you straight back, those tires are just going to get shredded by the bottom of that trailer. You see what I'm saying? Because as I'm pulling you, that's going to be rolling, so your tires are going to be pulling into that. So we'll pick it up and we'll set it over here. Yeah. Those two chains with no hooks, one hook on them, right? Just the ones with one hook. Same way we always do it, not that one. Yeah, you were right. Hey, we're just gonna have to be... That's fine. Yeah, hold on. This thing's a rust bucket. No, just on this one. You wanna, actually I guess I'll hook this up real quick. That's fine. You're gonna wanna spin that though. Other way. Flip the hook around. Are they set?
Yep.
All right. All right, what I need you to do is go sit in your tractor You don't have to sit in there, but release your trailer brakes so these airbags fill up so that I'm not crushing them when I'm setting it down, okay? Just the trailer brakes, not the tractor, so leave the tractor set, okay? I know you went and got a jacket.
Yeah, beautiful.
Hey, it worked, right?
Oh, fucking beautiful.
Well, there he goes. I just don't want those bags to crumble and break and pop and stuff, so he has the brakes released, they'll fill up with air, so then when I set it down, yeah, they'll be good. Those two are on, good. Yeah, these two are starting to fill up now. But this axle looks a little bent. Yeah, I know. Yeah, but look, it's bent. Look at the gap right here compared to the inner side.
So you fucked it up right here or what?
I don't know. Maybe. I mean, there's no way that we did it. We just lifted it up. I told you they were gonna pop. Roll forward a little bit. Roll forward a little bit. Yeah, pull forward a little bit, yeah. It just filled up. I can't wait till this cold is done, man. It looks like I gotta grease that thing again because it looks like it's getting a little on the slow side. You wanna get the VIN number and all that off that truck? Thank you. was a little bit more of a good leaner there. Back to this slow leg. Well, my truck was clean. Shiny. Crack that line and bleed it or something. Something's not right. Again, I bled it before and it went, started picking back up again. So I don't know if maybe it has a tiny little hole in it or something. It's sucking in air somewhere. I have no freaking idea.
I think that line's catching air.
Done. Just gotta do the billing here, then we'll get the heck out of here. Thanks for watching.